Jonathan Paula presents Game Time.
Greetings, Hotshot, and welcome to the final episode of the Uncharted Drake's Fortune Let's Play on the PlayStation 3. When we last left off, Nate told us we have to climb these stairs and re-enter the church. So as we continue Chapter 20, Race to the Rescue, let's grab Sully's help to open these big wooden doors as we begin the final area of the game. Hey, look out, pigeons. All hell's about to break loose. All right, so here we go, back inside this old church third time in this game now. We went through before and went through this exact same section, scurrying around from pew to pew trying to take everybody out. And then we went through the upper level and we opened up that window at the far end right there. And that was a section of the game. And now we're back for a third time and the whole place is crawling with sniper rifles and more bad guys and we have to do this all over again. And part of me kind of likes that they are repeating this section of the game. It's kind of like a neat concept to force the player through the same space repeatedly. But part of me is also kind of wondering, did they just run out of space on the game disc, so they had to use the same location multiple times? The fact that Uncharted 2 never does this lends me to believe that yes, it was a design element out of necessity and not necessarily out of desire. But even so, I don't really mind. The fact that you get to use the space in a different way each time makes it okay and it's still fun, because this time there's a bunch of sniper rifles, which is different than last time when there was a whole bunch of other guys. So it lends a new element and progress every time you go through. The first time it was like close quarters and grenades, the second time it was platforming, and now the third time it's sniper rifles and long range shit. And I'm completely out of ammo, so I'm just gonna start throwing grenades and stuff. I have a rocket launcher, so this could help. Not a rocket launcher, sorry, a grenade launcher. Although, I could go for a rocket launcher right about now. I'll tell you what. I think I got that guy with that. Did I get you? You dead?
Nice.
Alright, I have some more bullets here, so that's a start. I think this might be the last guy. But I'll wait for the music to tell me. Oh, I see a sniper rifle again. Alright, it's okay, it's okay. I can get him. There's so many people to shoot at, and I don't have all that many weapons or angles of attack for the whole thing. Come on, guys! Stop saying your Hail Marys and say hello to me. Say hello to Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Oh, my battery's gotta die. We gotta speed this up, fellas. Thanks. That'll do the trick. So, did these guys just come in from the same entrance? I cleared the back half of the church already. And now it seems like there's even more of them.
Come on, Sully. There should be a hidden passage right under the altar.
There should? Why didn't we do that from the get-go? You've been in this church three times now. You think you would take the time to investigate hidden passages beneath the altar the first time around? And how did Sully get to the back of the church without getting shot at like me? Jeez, this guy is so much of a leech. Oh, yeah, no big deal. Just move this 1,000-pound altar out of the way like it's a sofa.
Holy shit.
Great, we're going back underground again. It's just what I always wanted. Come on, Sully Sullenberger. It's Chapter 21. Golden Bones.
You wanna tell me what the hell's going on?
Drake didn't want to get the treasure off the island, Sully. He was trying to stop it from leaving.
What?
It's cursed or something. Look, I know it sounds crazy. You just gotta trust me.
Oh, look at the little rats. Neat. Didn't notice them the first time I played this. Yeah, Sully still hasn't seen any of those undead mutant Nazi gargoyles that we've been fighting for the last few videos. So, when we're like, it's cursed, he doesn't actually believe us. But when he starts seeing all of the gargoyles, and I think he might change his tune, I think he might change his tune. Just a little bit. Oh, what's this? A treasure? I do believe it is. The Golden Skull Rosary underneath the church. How fitting of a location for it to be found at. That was number 23. You might actually get to halfway before the end of the game. But until next time, I am Howard Cosell for ABC Sports with your Treasure Hunter update. Thanks, Howard, as always, and no need to be pessimistic. I mean, I could always go back and get all of the treasures later. I don't have to get them on my first playthrough. And in fact, that's actually exactly what I did. I got through, I think, on my blind run, I want to say I got like 29 or 30. I got about half of them. And then I used an online player's guide to find the rest. And speak of the devil, a sapphire and silver mask here for you to take to your next Halloween shindig. And look at the size of those ears. That man is crazy looking. Howard Cosell, ABC Sports. So I found it a lot easier to kind of focus on the gameplay the first time around and then at my own leisure go back and find the treasure as needed using a guide to cut down on all of the guesswork.
Oh, shit, it's the El Dorado gold statue we've been looking for the whole game!
And also my girlfriend and Navarro and Gabriel. Let's have a party, everybody's here. Oh, so are those guys.
You two should realize by now that I plan for every contingency.
Like me murdering 400 of your henchmen? You planned for that? That was your plan?
Down there. No heroics, please. Or I will kill her. Good. Now, if you'll just hang tight, we'll be with you in a moment.
Like a New York minute? Or like a cotton picking minute? Gotta be specific here.
It's magnificent. The craftsmanship. I've never seen anything like it before.
You would if you watched some of the films and journals I've been picking up.
The real treasure of El Dorado lies inside.
You gonna open that sarcophagus?
Open it!
You guys are crazier than you look and smell. Again, this thing's been buried for how many years and you just open it?
Oh my God.
Taking another play from the end of Raiders of the Lost Ark, this scene is very familiar.
Watch this.
I think Gabriel Roman just inhaled his last breath because...
Navarro.
I think he's going to be a gargoyle in a minute. Yep. Shit.
Adios, Jefe.
Jefe?
So little imagination.
That's disgusting.
So,
Navarro's plan the whole time was to let him find it and turn it into a gargoyle.
Navarro, that thing wiped out an entire colony. You don't know what you're doing.
Wrong. I'm the only person on this island who knows what the hell he's doing. Cargue la statua.
I thought for a minute there he was going to shoot his henchman and just leave.
Cuidado! You are so pathetic. All of you,
even the henchmen,
scrambling around for your petty treasures. Do you have any idea what this is worth?
The corpse?
For the right buyer?
Oh, the disease.
Levantalo!
Oh, he's not after the gold. He's after the undead mutant Nazi gargoyle turning serum inside the gold.
Oh,
that
no.
Makes sense,
what
actually.
The hell is that?
God.
Run!
See, now Sully's starting to believe
Jesus,
me.
Jesus, what are those things?
It's the Spaniards, Sully. They never left.
On the plus side, they are immortal, so they got that going for them.
My God. If that thing gets off the island...
You gotta stop him. I'll cover you from
here.
Thanks,
old man Rogers. Elena, come back! Nate Drake, he's to the rescue. He's gonna save his girlfriend from the gargoyles. Also Navarro. She's not really my girlfriend yet, but I mean, we're still working things out. I can hope, can I? I mean, I think we could be. We could make a great couple.
Come on, come on.
Reload, reload. Reload, reload, reload. All right, here we go. Keep on pressing, keep on going. Jump onto the gold statue because that didn't just leak poison out a second ago. Nate Drake, he's on the gold statue. We are reaching the climax of this adventure. This is thrilling, and why are the helicopter blades red? I don't understand that.
Huh. See you later, asshole.
What was that? I couldn't hear you. It was just a mumble. Hey, how you guys doing? I want you to come on down here and fight me hand to hand. I think it'll be fun. Oh, snap! Oh, shit! I did not think this one through. we are going to crash land the ship. I don't... Look out.
Oh. Oh, my God.
That was awesome. I hope Elena's okay, though. What's with the shaky camera angle? It's kind of a different style for the game cinematic.
Kill him!
Terrific. Now that we're finally off the island, we're inside of a giant firefight. Just what I need. Chapter 22. The Showdown. It all comes down to this. Now, we have a few bad guys behind all these crates, and the only weapon we have left in our arsenal is the shotgun. And of course, that nasty-looking guy with the red laser pointer in the center is Dave Navarro himself, the last remaining enemy in this game. Of course, we started our adventure so many chapters ago with zero enemies, and we picked up three along the way. The first was Gabriel Roman, who we just saw dispatched not long ago by becoming a gargoyle. And there goes little Navarro off like a little runt. And then the second enemy we encountered was Eddie Raja, who was pulled down into the depths of hell by one of the gargoyles. And I'm going to dispatch this last guy by my own bullets. Navarro takes a couple shots at you, then he hides. You have a few moments in between his aims where you can take out the bad guy. So you wait for him to take his clean shot, and then you have a couple seconds uninterrupted. And when he takes 1, 2, 3, then you have to duck. Because if he gets to that fourth moment, that's when you're screwed. I have to run and jump over here and pick up some more weapons. I have 5 bullets left, so this has to count here. Alright, there he goes. He's off again. Now I can go up and grab these other guys' ammo, and we can proceed to the third section of what is basically the final boss battle in the game. It's made up in stages. You gotta go from one section to the next, and there's no checkpoints in between, which definitely makes this, the last level in the game, pretty damn difficult if you make it. But if you take your time and you're patient and you follow the strategy... Oh shit! Circle, circle, circle! Yes! Dive to safety. Same stuff, gotta repeat. Navarro shoots 3 times. He gets 1 clean shot, and that gives you the clear to do this. Don't shoot my boxes away, pal. I need those. Alright, come on, take your shot, pal. Alright, good. I'm gonna take this guy out up here. All right, there he goes. He's off. I never liked your music anyway, Navarro.
Nowhere to hide now.
I hope to see you in hell.
Oh, there she is. Damsel in distress. Helicopter's about to fall off the side of this boat. And I gotta kill Navarro to make it happen. But there goes my weapon. Oh, no. Alright, he takes 2 shots, then you roll to the next one. Pretty easy pattern to follow, doesn't make this boss battle all that difficult. But I will say for Uncharted, it seems like kind of a weird game to have a boss battle. I mean, we've been platforming and treasure hunting this whole time, and then the whole game comes down to a fist fight on top of this boat. But that being said, it's a lot of fun. And as the sun sets over the harbor, so do his balls into his groin, because I just kicked him in. No you don't, Navarro. Get your mouth back here! Triangle, triangle, triangle! Square, square, square!
Yes! You're down for the count, pal. It's just been revoked.
Uncharted, yeah! You beat it on easy! Michael Bolton congratulates you on a job well done, yeah!
Oh, God.
Too bad your girlfriend's dead! You'll be fucking a corpse tonight, yeah!
Can you stand?
Oh, wait, I spoke too soon. She's alive,
right?
Here.
Oh, Nate!
And so is Navarro! A big twist of fate, yeah!
How is that strategy gonna get rid of Navarro? Oh, I see.
Adios, asshole.
Smile, you son of a bitch.
That was a great ending one-liner from Nate Drake. I love it. I nice capper to a beautiful story, a really fun game. And here we have a terrific ending. Cavalry coming in, happy ending. Nate gets the girl, Sully gets, I guess, those 30 trinkets I found.
Quite a day.
Yeah, save the world, triumph over evil. Pretty typical.
Really?
That's a shame we're leaving empty-handed, though.
Oh, well, you know what?
You can still have me.
I did manage to save one small thing.
Oh, she did get the ring after I dropped it on the ground next to FSD's rotting corpse.
I thought you might miss this.
Thanks.
Yeah.
They're gonna kiss you!
You two got a funny idea of romantic.
Sully!
Cock blocked again!
Wow, you look like hell.
You should see the other guys. Got us a boat.
We already have a boat.
Yeah, big boat.
I like this one better.
Olay.
Sully, you beautiful son of a bitch!
There's that one word
Barred
again.
Ordered off a couple of pirates who were too dead to care.
And as they ride off into the sunset, so ends another game time adventure. Nathan Drake got the girl, and yet, he still hasn't had a chance to bone her. Serious case of the blue balls here.
Sorry you didn't get your story.
Well, that's all right. There'll be other stories. You still owe me one.
I'm good for it.
And there you have it. The end of Uncharted by Naughty Dog, Drake's Fortune. A incredible game, so much fun. Excellent platforming, excellent dialogue, excellent voice acting, excellent graphics, fun story. Some elements were hit or miss every now and then, but overall, this was an extremely fun adventure. It was a pleasure let's playing it for you. And if I had to give this a rating, I would say it's probably like an 8 or a 9 out of 10. This is a really solid video game. And it was a launch title for the PlayStation 3 back when it came out, and it is still awesome today. So if you haven't played it, pick it up, because you can get it now for like 15 or 20 bucks. It isn't exclusive to the PlayStation 3, but that being said, it is awesome, it is worth it, and the sequels are even better.
Howard Cosell will take it from here with your cast read-off. Nolan North as Nate Drake, Emily Rose as Elena Fisher, and Richard McGonagall as Victor Sullivan. The rest of these people are a bunch of blums. Even Mr. Steve himself. Fonts provided by fonts101.com. Art and animation, Joe McGuffin. I should point out at this juncture that these credits have been sped up by 150%, and to keep up, especially in this accent, is extremely difficult. Mercury Bar Productions, Brent Mason, Adam Lane, Freddie Taylor, all great people, and the president of Sony Computer Entertainment Worldwide Studios is Phil Harrison. Tools and technology provided by Dave Manaconi. QA Test Supervisor, Ari Demarajajan. Continent Game Test Analysts are a bunch of people who get paid less than they ought to. Music Production Associates, Steve Onsu and Ernest Johnson. Orchestration by Alan Steinberger and J. Eric Schmidt. Floor Assistant was Kyle Gary. Senior Sound Designer, Paul Box. All of these people made this game possible. You should go and fund their Kickstarter campaign. I heard they want to paint their backyard a new color. Why would you paint a yard? I don't know. I meant house. Here, Jose Flores, Albert Perez, Shift Supervisor, ATG. I don't even know what that means. When I was alive, video games were Pong and Pac-Man. Software manual writers. I understand that. They literally write the manual. It is a thankless job, to say the least. Voice talent for Japan. Congratulations, you have a job only in one country. That is awesome, just like me. All I do now is provide color commentary for Jonathan's Let's Play. But I will have to go now. My time is running up. We're getting to the Korean section. For game time, one more time, my name is Howard Cosell for ABC Sports with your final Treasure Hunter update. Thank you for watching. Excellent, Howard. That was tremendous. Thank you for joining us. We're reaching the end of the credits roll here, and it is time to say goodbye. Our very next Let's Play is going to be Donkey Kong Country on the Super Nintendo, and I hope you're looking forward to that. But unfortunately for now, for me, that'll have to do it for this episode of Game Time and this Let's Play.
If you're lucky, maybe we'll do Uncharted 2 or 3 somewhere down the line. But until then, thank you for watching and listening. My name is Jonathan Paula. Special thanks to all these people, and I hope to see you right back here in the very near future. Copyright 2007, Sony Computer Entertainment America.